Hey friends, welcome to KNACKK. In this tutorial, you will learn to make this pop art drawing. We'll make this call out with the help of some basic shapes. We are going to use some high saturated colors because when it comes to pop art drawing, only high saturated colors are used. It's going to be fun. Let's start it right here. So before we start with drawing, turn off this align art to pixel grid button and make sure that the smart guides are on. We're going to start with drawing the background. Pick the rectangle tool and draw an artboard sized rectangle. Remove its stroke. And for the fill color, I'll go with this RGB red. That's all for the background, but let me hide this background rectangle for now so that you can have a better view of whatever is happening on the screen. All right. Okay, now get the line tool. Come at the center of the artboard and draw a line towards this left corner of the artboard. Fine. Give it a stroke of 10 points and change the color of the stroke to this orange color. Open stroke panel. Keep the cap set round and make sure that the stroke is aligned to center. Make it dashed line. Set the dash value at 0 and cap value at 21. Change its width profile to width profile 4. No, I want smaller dots towards the center. So I'll press this button to flip along this profile style. Now with this line under selection, open effect menu, go for distort and transform, pick transform. Here, keep the scaling at 100%. No movement is required. Rotate it by 3 degrees. Make sure this corner reference point is selected here. And we need copies, a lot more copies. Make it 119. Wow. This line is under selection. You have to copy it. Now paste it in front. Open stroke panel. Change its weight to 150 points. Change the cap option to this butt cap. We don't want these dashes anymore. Okay, now transform effect has already been applied on this path, but we'll have to make some corrections. So keeping it selected, open the appearance panel. You can get it from window menu. Okay, so here open this transform effect options. We have to make a couple of changes. First, change this angle of rotation to 15 degrees. And this time we need only 23 copies. Nice. Let's reduce its opacity. Make it 49%. Good enough. Now again copy this path. Paste it in front. Change the color of the stroke. I'm going for this yellow. Reduce the stroke weight to 130 points. Alright. Transform effect will again need some corrections. This time, change the angle of rotation to 60 degrees and reduce the number of copies to 5. Okay. Get the rotate tool now. Press and hold Alt key and click here at this anchor point. It has set the axis of rotation at this point. Rotate it by 7.5 degrees. Nice. Get the ellipse tool now. Press and hold Alt key and click here at the center of the artboard. Enter 1080 for the width and 600 for height. Give it a white fill. Change the stroke color to black and set the stroke weight at 16 points. Now keeping it selected, get the add anchor point tool. Now what you have to do is add a few anchor points on this path. You don't need to be precise, put them at random distance. That's it. Now select this whole shape with selection tool, open effect menu, here distort and transform, and this time you have to go with this pucker and bloat. Here enter -25%. Alright, open the stroke panel and change this corners option to round join. Now copy this shape and this time paste it in back of the original shape. Okay, copy in back is under selection right now. Remove its stroke and change its fill to this yellow color. Copy in back is still under selection. Move it a little towards left, a bit downwards too. Use arrow keys to move it with precision. I think this much is enough. Pick the star tool now. Draw a star almost here. Change its fill. I'll go with this color. Now draw another star. You don't need to be specific about the spots and size of the stars. Draw it the way you like. Okay, let me put another one. And I'll draw last one here. Okay, select all these stars now. Or you may select one and press this select similar objects button to select them all. All star shapes are under selection. Change their stroke weight to 5 points. And change the width profile to width profile 4. Now I want this thicker portion of the stroke at outer side. So I'll get the rotate tool and I'll rotate these shapes like this. Yeah, it looks fine now. Get the line tool. Draw a line here like this. Draw another one here. I'm gonna draw it for all the stars. Okay, this line is under selection. Press this select similar objects button to select them all. Increase the stroke weight to 8 points. Change the width profile to width profile 4. And our drawing completes here. We have to unhide the background now. So come to layers panel and unhide it from here. Nice. Now finally we have to chop off this extra portion of our drawing that is lying out of the artboard. Quickly get the rectangle tool and draw an artboard sized rectangle. Now press Ctrl A to select everything. Open object menu. Here clipping mask and choose make. And it completes our drawing. Try your hand at this and you may experiment with some different shapes for the callout. I hope you like this tutorial. Share your reviews and suggestions in the comment section. And let me remind you that you may share any queries about Adobe Illustrator here. We'll be happy to help. That's all for now. Thank you very much for your time.